Stand to your feet. I want to welcome you to the house of the Lord. And why don't you welcome somebody else that's outside of your row? Just go out and welcome somebody to the house of the Lord. Praising the Lord, about praising Him on the high sounding cymbal, about praising Him on the harp, about praising Him on the strings and on the drums and all the instruments, and praising Him with a loud voice because He's a good God. Heaven isn't silent because there's always praise and adoration and worship going on. But there will be a moment of silence when we do get raptured up. And we are just going to be in awe of the Master. So there are times when God does want us to just be still and be silent, but there's other times that we got to come in. The Bible says, enter His gates with thanksgiving and into His courts with praise. Amen. And that's what we've come to do, is to praise Him. We cannot be silent because our God is good, and we will praise and adore Him. We will loud Him. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. With all our hearts, we bless You, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We cannot be silent. Hallelujah.
can take it.
That's right, nobody can praise him for you. Only you know what God has brought you through. Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Give me some room so I can thank him. That's right, when I look at where God has brought me from, I can't just be silent and I can't just be still. When I think about what a mess I was and God have mercy on me, I can't be still, I can't be silent.
Come on, praise him in the dance, praise him in the dance. Hallelujah, hallelujah. You've been circling for years. Today the walls fall. Today the walls fall. Come on, give you some room so you can thank him. Oh yeah.
I praise you.
I praise you.
I praise you.
praise you.
I praise you.
I praise you.
You're breaking the chains.
I praise you.
I praise you.
I praise you.
I praise you.
Praise you. Praise you.
The people that are religious, we're not amongst the people that need to be pumped and encouraged every Sunday, but they know how to get a hold of God. Hallelujah. We're amongst the people who are warriors, a warring people that war on behalf of the kingdom of heaven. Hallelujah. For the souls that need Jesus. Yes. And it's through praise, through thanksgiving. Hallelujah, that God gives us the breakthrough. Hallelujah. Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Yeah, let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Oh, let God arise and his enemies scattered. Oh, let God arise. Let God arise. God arise. Let God arise.
God arise.
Let God arise.
God arise.
Let God arise.
God arise.
Let God arise.
God arise.
Let God arise.
God arise.
God arise.
God arise.
Yeah. Our job is just to be in his presence with our mind fixed on him, not on the problem, not on how it's going to be solved. Oh, we are living in the days of an open heaven. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I praise you. I praise you. I thank you. I declare some of you open up your mouth and just start declaring what you believe God's doing in your life, what you believe God's doing in this surrounding neighborhood. Just start declaring it by faith. Hallelujah. Freedom, deliverance, breakthrough. I declare it. Oh, freedom, deliverance, and breakthrough. Power in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Come on, declare. Declare. Come on. Healing. Healing.
Healing.
Healing.
Healing.
Deliverance.
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 I'm going to be quick. Tuesday, get to prayer. Wednesday, come learn God's word. On Thursday, you better be part of a life group because God is about to send an explosive blessing to your family. Amen? You need to get on Friday. You need to join someone else. Go to a fellowship. Have a barbecue. Invite me. I'll be there. And then on Saturday, get connected with somebody. Thursday, Friday of this week, if you're married and you have a husband or wife, you want to get here for Harmony, amen, our marriage conference, amen. You're not going to want to miss. God is about to deposit something great into your marriage, amen. And if you believe it, we're going to keep on this spirit, amen. I'm going to ask the ushers if they would quickly come with the offering and the tithes, amen. We're going to give it to God, amen. Just let's give the Lord a wave offering. Say, thank you, God. Thank you, God, for everything you're doing, how you love me, amen. Thank him in advance for what's going to happen this week, amen, at Gateway, at New Community, and at our marriage conference this week, amen. You need to sign up, talk to someone in the foyer, amen. God bless you. And if your children have not signed up for the kids' choir, you want to get them signed up, please do that at the back, amen. Amen, amen. Turn to your neighbor and give them the biggest smile. If you don't know them, tell them your name. Say, welcome to Apostolic Jubilee.
Trust in God.
I believe,
come on, say, I believe.
I believe, I believe.
Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Well, I can truly say I think we're louder than Seattle Seahawks fans. Amen. Y'all brought your game to worship God here today. Praise the Lord, everybody. Amen. Everybody on the balcony, on the bottom floor, we are so ecstatic to have you at Apostolic Jubilee Center. The usher team and the children's ministry right now, they're going to be escorting our children out to children's ministry. You can follow them in the foyer, could be with them, and we thank God for our children's ministry. How many appreciate our children's ministry? Amen. So, amen. Everything that we do is the overflow of our prayer life. Amen. If you do not have a prayer life, our response to everyday situations is going to be what our flesh feels like. Amen. You ever yell at your children because they just ask you, what's for dinner? And all of a sudden, there is a prompting in your spirit that says, you need to pray. Everything we do is based off our prayer life. This is the importance of having a connection with God. And this month we are dedicating our Sundays towards prayer. Because what we do in life is based off how much we give to prayer. I'm going to read the portion of scriptures, and then the choir, they're going to sing a song that is tied into our sermon today. It's called Living Under an Open Heaven. How many want to live under an open heaven? How many want your home to be under an open heaven? Matthew chapter 6, verse 9 through 13, it says, in this manner, therefore pray, read with me, our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And do not lead us into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours, everybody say yours, is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever and ever. Amen. Amen. I want you to just lift up your hands, and I want us just to get connected, knowing that everything is produced through prayer. Our relationships. I know we're having a marriage conference this weekend, Thursday and Friday. Prayer. Our connection to God will compel us to love others. I want you to just lift up your hands, and I want you to sing with them as they sing Spirit Breakout. We want a heavenly invasion to hit this place in Jesus' name.
Praise, can you hear it?
everything we need right now. Whatever you are worrying about, whatever you are focused on, whatever you are in need of, God has an abundant supply. And the only difference is somebody that has faith and obedience to receive and say, God, I want to be connected right now to the kingdom of God. I want you just to lift up your hands right now. I want you just to worship God, knowing that everything that you need right now, this moment, God has it. Everything that we need, whatever you are in need of, God has it. That's it. Just stand. All this week you've been praying. It's like a map. You're hiking to the waterfall. When you get to the waterfall, don't just look at it. Get underneath it. Get drenched. The kingdom of heaven is open amongst us right now. Whatever you are in need of, turn the vocabulary from I need to I receive. I receive it right now. I receive it right now in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, amen. Don't your neighbor say, everything I need. Everything I need is in the kingdom. Amen. Waiting for me to claim it. In Jesus' name, you may be seated. Matthew chapter 6 reveals two real priorities of prayer. First, intimacy with God that is expressed through worship. Our response to the greatness and power of God. This is why we say, Our Father, which art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. It's an act of worship. And then second is to bring God's kingdom here on earth, establishing his dominion over the needs of mankind. This is why we pray, your kingdom comes. Because when his kingdom invades ours, he takes dominion. Amen. When his kingdom comes to this earth, every situation, every enemy that has come against you, when Jesus is in the house, he takes over. Amen. The only difference is, like this water bottle, is the water is God's unlimited supply to mankind. The only thing that's keeping it from flowing is us. When we do not connect to God through faith and obedience. God wants to do good. Don't you neighbor and say, God wants to do good to you. Will you receive it? Amen. Everything and anything that we want from God, we will have to pray it out of heaven. This is the power of staying focused and persistent until there is a breakthrough. You came in the latter blessing and rain of these afternoon services. But there was somebody this morning in our first service that had to press a little bit harder to get a breakthrough. Had to praise a little bit harder to get a breakthrough, to create an environment that we are being blessed by right now. Amen. This is why all of us have to be participators in worship and in our church services, because the kingdom of heaven suffers violence, but the violent take it by force. When the choir was singing, I cannot be silent. It was a force to connect with the kingdom of God. Amen. To provide a connection. Everything that we need is in heaven. And if we do not have an anticipation to receive it, we won't. Amen. For where there is anticipation, there will be miracles. Come on, man. If you don't brush your teeth and put on cologne, you're never going to get a girl. Come on, sisters. Don't get yourself an updo and put on a belt. I'm just going to wait for the Lord. No, God's waiting for you. Amen. We can't just sit around until the kingdom hits us. We got to do something to provide an environment, a gateway between us and God. You know that everything that you need, we said, is in heaven and only in heaven. You see, everything in this earth is limited. Amen. Humans are limited in what they can give you. Our banks are limited. Our government is limited. Our jobs are limited. But I serve a God that is not limited. I said, I serve a God that is not limited. And if you sit around depending on the external surroundings of your life, you're always going to be missing the mark because everything around you is limited. That is why you have to look up. That's why you got to look to the hills which cometh your help. We preached last week, that's why you need to stay in prayer, because the further you stay away from prayer, the more life stinks. But prayer is a sweet aroma before God. Everything around us is limited, but I serve a God that is not limited. And I want to let you know that your miracle is not found in complaining. Your miracle is not found in people. Your miracle is found in God. And God inhabits the praises of his people. And wherever there's going to be praise, there's going to be miracles. Wherever there's going to be a people of God that is going to search and seek after God, there will be the kingdom. I wish I had somebody that say, I'm not sitting around in this mess. I'm going to create worship and praise because God is everything that I need. Amen. And when we pray, what we're telling God is, I need you to invade this situation. Amen. When we stay in connection to God, we are asking him, please, my life is out of order. My job is falling apart. My finances, I'm going under. But I need the kingdom of God to invade the situation, to bring everything in order. And when God shows up, bam. Amen. When God, that's like a problem in your house or in the city, and then wait till the cops come. They come to bring order. Even if they gotta taser you. I want to let you know, when we call on Jesus, he's going to come in. And his enemies, that's why the choir says, let God arise and his enemies be scattered, right? Because when God is in the house, every knee shall bow, every tongue must confess, every demon in hell, Jesus. Come on, I don't care if it's big demon, little demon, oldest demon. When Jesus shows up, Jesus. That's the importance. I'm lifting up Jesus. I'm connecting to the kingdom of God. Because whenever God is in a situation, we're going to have miracles, signs. And I dare somebody, 30 seconds, shout with the voice of triumph. Yeah.
your neighbor and say, neighbor, I'll give you 30 seconds. Get out of the way. Because God's about to invade this home. God's about to invade this situation. And I don't know if my heel's going to fly. I don't know if my hand's going to fly. But the kingdom of God is coming to my house. The kingdom of God is invading my mind. The kingdom of God is invading my finances. The kingdom of God is invading my house right now. Where's those that have faith? Wait till my daddy shows up. Our Father, which art in heaven. Wait till my daddy shows up. Wait till my daddy shows up. Try to bring fear in my life, but I do. Wait till my daddy shows up. Invade this community now. Turn it upside down. Let your kingdom reign. Hallelujah. Woo. Woo. This is the power of prayer. Listen. When you're done with prayer, you shouldn't be stressed out. It's not a pity party session. You enter into prayer and say, Dada, you got this. You got this. In the area of finances, you got it. In the area of relationships, you got it. In the area of the devil, you got it. You're my dad. You got everything that I need. I'm the pastor. If you're messing with my son, I'm coming after you. If you're putting my children in danger, I'm coming after you. And how much more our spiritual father? When the enemy has you put into a corner, oh no, you don't. Oh, no, you don't. I need somebody to shout because your daddy got your back. Your daddy got your back. A thousand might fall on my left. A thousand at my right. When my enemy comes in against my flesh, they stumble. But my daddy got me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Listen, King David understood that. He said, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. There's not one thing my God cannot do. I dare somebody to shout because everything you need is in God. Come on. I don't need a man. I don't need drugs. I don't need friends. As long as I got King Jesus. I might be moving from my house, but as long as I got King Jesus. I need somebody to demonstrate you'll be okay if all you got is Jesus. Hallelujah. He's the source of all things. Everybody say all things. in Him. It's in Him. Amen. Provision, healing. It's in Him. Amen. Why are you complaining when everything that you need is in God? Our Father. Everybody, just lift up your hands. Call on Daddy. Come on, call on Daddy. Amen. When I was little, they said, call on Jesus. And then the church would say, He'll answer prayer. Call on Jesus. Come on, somebody call on Jesus here today. I could call on Mama, but she's limited. I could call on my earthly father, but he might not have money. But the first person I go to is Jesus. Jesus. Amen. As you're making your way out, I'm going to ask you a question. Have you tried Jesus? Got anybody on this side? Have you tried Jesus? Mama's over here. Have you tried Jesus? He's all right. He's all right. All right. All right. Yes. Anybody a witness? I tried him. I dare you to tell your neighbor, I tried him and he over exceeds my expectations. I tried him over and over and over again. And he always oversees my expectations. Amen. Listen, when the Broncos win today, and they will, people are going to party up like it's 1999. But when they wake up, it ain't going to change their situation. It ain't going to change the fact that they are still in their problem. But the church has a solution. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday, Monday, Tuesday. Jesus is the same yesterday, today, and forever. If you believe it, shout with the voice of truth. Must always approach prayer with Jesus, Daddy. The one who has unlimited resources. I call on you first. And then, hallowed be your name. This is an expression of praise, of adoration. In the book of Revelations, praise and worship are the primary activities of heaven. And because it is the primary activities in heaven, so should it be with the believers. Church, praise and worship just isn't a Sunday thing. It's not just because God's good to me at this moment. Praise and worship is what I do every day of my life. My Father, who has all things, you are worthy to be praised. And I connect with angels in heaven. Listen, when you worship God, you are connecting with the normal activity. You know, people say, they come to our church, man, what do you guys do? You guys are on fire. Like I said, the leaders, I said, this church, we are the jalapeno of the community. We are the jalapeno
of the community. Because anybody that makes salsa, you know, you could have salsa, but if it doesn't have jalapeno, it doesn't spice it up. Honey, we got everything plus the Holy Ghost. We shake it all. You put us in a blender. I mean, hair will fall off. Heels will fall off. Ties will. We're the jalapeno of the community. Amen. We're not doing anything different. We're not doing nothing out of the ordinary. We are just connecting with the activity that has been going on forever. And that is worship. That in all things, God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. And he's worthy to be praised. And when you say, our Father who has all things, I connect with heaven. And I declare, holy, holy, holy is the Lord. And so all of a sudden, there is heaven and there is a collision with earth that is all in agreement. That God is good. And he's Lord over all. And it provides a connecting point between heaven and earth. When we join with heaven in worship, all of a sudden we start getting the benefits of heaven. Let me tell you something. The benefits of heaven is joy and peace. Amen. The benefits of heaven is rejuvenation. Amen. You don't see an angel with a walker. Let me tell you something. Every day we're being renewed. Amen. One of our benefits in Psalms 103 is that he renews us like a young eagle. Amen. I'm not telling you 50 years and older to go buy an Abercrombie sweatshirt. I'm young. No, you're not that young. Your body isn't that young. Leave that to your children. But I'm young in spirit. I'm stronger than ever. Because I got heaven with me. Amen. Worship is the primary activity in heaven. So it is here on earth. We must be worshipers at all times. Not for a favor, but just because God is God. Because he's worthy to be praised. Amen. Some of you serve God for favors. Come on, some of you are here because you need God to pay your rent. And then God pays your rent for 6 months and you don't show up to church. I'm gonna preach on this. Amen. You're serving God until you get a hookup, and then where are you at? Amen. Now you're too busy for church. Amen. You were more closer to God in a one-bedroom apartment, but now you got upgraded to a house. Now you got excuses. Let me tell you something. Our worship for God does not change based off conditions. Our worship to God is because he's good and he's worthy to be praised. And in heaven, this is what they do all day, every day, for all of eternity. And so as we praise God, we're saying, God, you are Father in all things. There is nothing too hard for you. Everything that I need is in heaven. And I connect with heaven right now in my worship to you. Because you are my ultimate supply in all things. Amen. I wonder if we would worship until we connect with the primary activity in heaven. Amen. This is why we have prayer revivals Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. We're going to be having 24-hour prayer this month. Why? We just want to connect with heaven. We just want to be in agreement with heaven. Amen. And then it says, your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. 2 Corinthians chapter 3, verse 17 says, now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is what? Burden? There is unhappiness? There is liberty. Everybody say liberty. How many felt liberty today? How many feel liberty here? There is therefore no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. I know you've been hearing the voices of Satan saying you're good for nothing. Look at, I know what you did yesterday, but you need to tell them that was yesterday. I'm not defined by my yesterday. I'm in the present, and God has given me a gift today. It's called grace. Where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. Amen. Through prayer, we are to exercise the authority given to us. What's that authority? Jesus said, I give you the keys of the kingdom. And whatever you bind on earth shall have been bound in heaven. And whatever you loose on earth shall have been loosed in heaven. You know, when we declare God's heaven, the kingdom of God on this earth, what we are saying is, if it does not exist in heaven, it is to be loosed on this earth. Come on, somebody. If it doesn't exist in heaven, then you do not exist in my home. And I want to let you know, when you break into that mode and you feel the kingdom of God, which is right here, God is here. The windows of heaven is here. What you need to do is, see, I'm going to take it back for a moment. I told you last week, this is the importance of every believer pressing through in the Spirit. Amen. Because what starts to happen is, you know, Satan's been attacking our minds. Satan has a strategy. He's had a strategy plan since, you know, yesterday. This is how we're going to attack the church so that we can hinder the move of God. We're going to bring distraction. We're going to send them to go buy buffalo wings for the Super Bowl at 12:45. They're going to miss church. Amen. And so when we get to church, Sister Isella in the choir, they're singing, and there's some resistance. Amen. People are like, I'm just here because I don't want the pastor to be texting me. Amen. I'm just here because, you know, my football team or soap opera doesn't start till 4, so might as well. And let me tell you something. This is where we just keep on praising. And we keep on worshiping, and we start breaking through the barriers until we get to a place where we feel faith increase. When you feel faith increase, we're tapping into the kingdom of God. When you see people go from this, there's liberty. That means, come on, let's pray. Let's start acting on this. God is in this house. This is why we need everybody. Just, God, thank you. We praise you. We love you. You are awesome. God, change the soul of a visitor. God, change so-and-so. Change. Minister to the pastor. God, let the anointing break the yoke. During that time, we're asking God, you know, Father, we need you. You are unlimited supply. We thank you. We love you. We thank you. You're changing this atmosphere, God. We need the kingdom of God. And then all of a sudden, bam, there's increase. The presence of God comes in our environment shifts. This is the moment where you change your wording from, God, heal my body, to, ooh, God is with us. Heaven is amongst us. And if there's no sick angel up in heaven, God, I rebuke it out of my body. I'm healed in the name of Jesus. This is a moment where you don't ask, you receive it. I'm healed. I claim my healing. I wish I had somebody just to live in obedience. Just be obedient to your faith and start declaring things as so they are right now. Amen. This is why you got to declare publicly when you feel the shift of the Holy Ghost. You got to say, ooh, nudge your neighbor and say, change is coming. I feel in the environment, change is on its way. You got to declare it. I want to give a testimony. My wife, she prophesied over a sister last week, and she told me, she said, honey, I don't know if I just saw in my spirit a bunch of money being placed into this sister's hand. And so I prophesied and I told her that, you know what, I see money coming to you. I see money in your hands. Let me tell you something, kingdom connection. Amen. Because when God fills us up, we let it out. We let it out to the people all around. Oh, come on. This is, it gets old if what we've experienced these last 30 minutes in the presence of God, if you don't ever release it to somebody else. I mean, how fat of a Christian spiritually can you get? Ooh, that was a good blessing. Ooh, that was a good preaching. And let me tell you something. You get filled up so you can say, in the name of Jesus, the kingdom of God is upon you. Receive right now. I got a testimony. One of the brothers, they told me that this sister said this week, Her old company back paid her. And I'm not talking about just a couple dollars. I'm talking about hundreds and hundreds and hundreds. Come on, somebody. 100, 200, 500, 600, 700, 800. You know why? Because somebody received the kingdom and she released it in the name of Jesus. If it does not exist in heaven, it does not exist in our home. I want somebody to cancel out drugs. There ain't no crackhead up in heaven. You could put up with it all you want, but that is not the will of God. The will of God is that when the kingdom of God invades this earth, you have the dominion because you are the representation of Jesus. Cancel, get out. What are you doing here? In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I dare somebody 30 seconds. Cancel it out. If there it isn't in heaven. Confusion. We rebuke it in the name of Jesus. We cancel you out. Because if it doesn't exist in heaven, it does not exist here. That means you need to tell this body, you need to line up to the kingdom of God right now. Mine, you need to line up to the kingdom of God right now. I refuse anything less than to walk and live in God's kingdom. This is the power of prayer. We say, Father, you have all things. Father, I connect with heaven in agreement that you are God and you are worthy of all praise. And I stand here as an open door so that heaven can invade my family, can invade my mindsets, can invade my spirit. Spirit, break out. Break down the barriers. Amen. Listen, church, if you do not open your mouth and declare, you're like this. God wants to do good, but I'm too scared. What if I say something and it doesn't happen? And then God's like, man, there's so much more blessing. When you open up, when you put away fear and you put away disobedience and you say, I feel the presence of God and I'm going to.
healing, yes. Deliverance, yes. Come on, some of you might think I'm crazy, but I'm crazy to receive my miracle. Listen, listen. I remember when Mama Alicia, she stood up behind the congregation and she said, the lawyers told me that my son is going to spend many, many years in prison. I'm talking about how many years? They said they're going to spend several years in prison. But she said, but God is going to do a miracle. She stood right here under an open heaven and said, the lawyers gave up, the judge brought a judgment, but I believe God can cancel. I want to let you know that crazy guy running around the aisles, he's here today free. I dare you. I dare you to get connected to heaven and start declaring, I'm coming out. I'm coming out. My children are having breakthrough in the name of Jesus. Amen. Sit down. But I dare you, at least 10 people, 30 seconds, shout and praise God, because there is a kingdom invasion. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! If it doesn't exist in heaven, I refuse to put up with it here on this earth. You need to go home. You need to go home, go into all the rooms. I cancel this, I cancel that. In the name of Jesus. You get some oil, some olive oil, Crisco, I don't know what you use. Get some melted manteca, lay your hands on your children. Cancel every attack of the enemy in the name of Jesus. You're crazy. No, I'm not. I'm living in the kingdom. I dare some crazy apostolic church your neighbor and say, whatever plan the enemy has against you, I cancel it in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I'm walking in the kingdom. I'm talking in the kingdom. I'm living in the kingdom. I will not put up what is not in heaven. In the name of Jesus, I cancel you out. I cancel you out. My praise is louder. My praise is louder. My praise is louder than any situation. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Two options right now. These next 30 seconds, you got two options. You can look around and wait for your miracle, or you can look up and receive it right now in the name of Jesus. I dare you, somebody, to look up. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It's the kingdom. It's here. It's amongst us. I'm getting out of this. I'm breaking out of this. I'm canceling in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah! Kindly with kingdom authority. Just look at your neighbor. And if they're still like this, You say, I cancel that out in the name of Jesus. Let there be joy. Let there be freedom. Let there be liberty and deliverance in the house. Somebody shout. Come to you, not in. Ooh. I come to you in the Spirit. The Spirit of God is upon me. The Spirit of God is upon me. That you get filled up so that you can give it away. Hallelujah. We got angels. Angels are amongst us. The hand of God is amongst us. Take back. Lay your hand on your children and say, I'm taking you back. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I'm taking it back. I'm taking it back. Hallelujah. The Spirit of God is upon you. That's it. Use that kingdom authority. Pray with somebody. Lay your hands on them. Enough is enough. I'm an open heaven. I'm an open heaven. Depression, don't be trespassing in this house. Discouragement, you are not allowed. As from me and my house, we will serve the Lord. You can't find it in the clubs. You can't find it in the alcohol. Your only provision is going to be in the Lord. You can't find it with another prescription. It's only going to be in the Lord. I say, why don't you just lift up your hand? We are under an open heaven right now. Just receive it. Receive. Don't you pray. Don't you ask. You declare it. You receive it right now. God needs us to pray, church. We are His connection to this earth. We are this connection to our community.
Just lift up your hands, and as just wherever you're at, we're not going to be long. Just remain standing. Philippians chapter 4, verse 19. My visiting friend, you can sit down. Philippians 4, 19 says, and my God shall supply all your needs. Everybody say, all your needs. I'll let you know, I serve a God that can supply every need. My spiritual father can supply every need according to his riches. That's why we need the kingdom of God to invade every situation, because where he's at, he has everything we need. He has everything we need. But where are those riches at? In glory. By Christ Jesus. He has everything that we need in the kingdom of heaven. And the authorizer of these riches is Jesus. You can't find it by just looking around. You can't find it by just depending on people. This is the power of prayer. I speak to every marriage that you feel like your marriage is lacking in an area. You do not need to long for somebody else to feel that area that even they could not feel it. You need the power of God to fill a void. And it's through prayer. I want to let you know, whatever your excuse is of why you're doing the things you're doing, it's just the result of lack of praying. God has everything you need. Says, give me this day my daily bread. My God shall supply everything that you need. And it's in the kingdom of God. And all you need to do is say, Father, you have all things. And I call upon you. I love you. You are my Father. I worship you because the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. The earth is your footstool. I worship you because even before I bring a petition, if you do not answer it, I still love you. My devotion is like the Hebrew boys. If God does not deliver me from this fire, we still will not bow down to you. Father, I need your kingdom. I need every good supply, everything that you have. I need every supply that you have to cancel out everything that is not in heaven in my home right now. And I believe that you can supply all my needs according to your riches and glory. Father, give us this day right now everything that we need. You know what's the beauty of prayer? I want my wife to come. The more we know God, the more we become like him. The more we image him. And my wife, she vocalized something that I was thinking, and she gets all the credit because she vocalized it. You know, the more you draw closer to God and the more you fall in love with God, the more you display your love to your spouse. And the more you just want to be close to them. And the more you just want to love on them because Jesus loved you. This is the beauty. You can't give what you don't have. You can give to a limit. And if they do not fulfill what you want, and then you bring it up. Well, I done this, I do this, and you can't even do that. But true love sacrifices. And you know what I'm praying here today? I'm praying that love would invade this house. That even during worship, there's husbands and wives holding hands, embracing, just, I love you too. I thank God for you. Looking for the day that love would invade this house, that even as we're so full with love that we're feeling right now, you see the husband. God bless you, Pastor. That love would invade this house, that you know what, your neighbor, your friend from the God bless you, appreciate you, you're so awesome. You know what, that just love would just spell throughout this whole place. You know what, because God is love. God is love. And you cannot give something that you are not connected to. All of my needs, God, if it's love, if it's attention, God, you're looking down on me right now. You love us right now for just who we are. You're looking for some kind of security and self-esteem. I want to let you know, you're only going to find it through prayer. Not in the attention of people, because they are limited, but in God. And this is why we need to maintain that connection with God. Everything that we do depends on how we pray. And if we don't got a prayer life, there is no connection. Just like the water, just going. Even if you wanted to love, you can. Even if you wanted to believe God, you can. The more you connect with there, I tell you, Tuesday night is a time of connection. We come to prayer meeting. God is moving. I mean, we could camp out in this place on Tuesday nights. We're getting ready at the end of this month to have a 24-hour prayer. You just have a desire to have more of a kingdom invasion hit every area of our life. And it's only going to be when you have passion for His will to be done. I want you just to raise your hand wherever you're at. Simple talks with God. God, I love you. You're my Father. You are everything I need. You're my dad, daddy, Abba. You care for me. You see the sparrow that falls in. You care for them. How much more your children? God, I just connect with heaven right now. Right now. You don't really need our praise as much as what's going on in heaven. It is a 24-hour worship service. But yet, my praise draws you. My praise will cause you to look down and respond to my praise. This biggest sinner on the face of the earth. And if people knew what I did, they'd be showing me. But yet, God, my simple hallelujah draws you to me. So I ask that your will be done right now. Your will is for me to live in the kingdom. Every good gift, everything that you have in heaven is being given right now. I told our first service, if an angel had permission to come and speak to each and every one of us, he would tell you, I don't know what worry is, but whatever you're worrying about. Where I'm from, your God has everything you need. And you know, that one that you're always beating up on yourself, God is always talking about you. And as much as we were created to worship this God, there's something about you down here that when you align yourself to His kingdom, He pours His love, He pours His power. How is it? How does it feel to have a choice to worship God? I was created. You were created with a choice. How does it feel? What causes you? And the angels are thinking, why aren't you connected to God when you have this choice? You know what else they would tell you? God has gifts. He wraps it up and he says, to Jessica, he says, angel, go send it to her, for I have a gift. Jennifer, God has a gift just for you. And all it takes is just that kingdom connection. Just lift your hands and I receive every good gift that you have given me. For every good gift comes from God above. Church, there has to be an awareness that everything we need is found up there. And it's our worship and our obedience that brings heaven to us. It's that every need that you need, everything that you want, God has it. You just gotta stay connected. Also say, why are you so mad at somebody? And you use that excuse, well, I'm just so offended. As a pastor, I want to let you know that is no excuse, because prayer will cause you to be more like Jesus. Because where Jesus is, there is forgiveness. Well, you don't know what they did to me. What did they do to Jesus? Yet He forgave us. Living with offense is not being kingdom connected. And the enemy will blind you and say, it's okay to be offended. It's okay to live with unforgiveness. And God is saying, no, that's not my character. I forgive you every day. My blood has forgiven you and you are washed. And what you do, I throw it into the sea of forgiveness. Church, we need to pray and pray deeper. I say, just make me more like you, God. Let me mirror you. Let me, everywhere I go, there with Jesus. They know Jesus. There's something about you. That jalapeno church, there's something about. Simply just being kingdom connected. I want you to just lift up your hands right now, wherever you're at. The Bible says, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I want you to repeat after me, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I want to let you know, you can forgive right now. You can maintain a life of forgiveness.